right, it's good to have everybody with us this morning. Let's look at 2 Kings chapter 23. The last couple of weeks we had looked at why we use the King James Bible and why we teach eternal security. And so now we're getting back to our study, going through these stories in your Old Testament, which I know we're, maybe halfway through the Old Testament here in 2 Kings, but we're actually almost through all the stories. We're about toward the end because the next sections aren't history. They're different sections, so it'll move probably quicker when we get there. But where we are in the history is that before this, in 2 Kings chapter 21, there was Manasseh, and he was king for 55 years, and he was about the most evil king that had ever been for Israel. He did all kinds of evil, just things you wouldn't even want to mention. Such wicked, evil king there. And so then after him comes this guy, Josiah. And Josiah becomes the king. And I, when I sent out the email for today, I said that the topic is that Josiah turns Judah to the Mosaic Law. Because in 2 Kings 22 and verse 8, see, what had happened was God had his temple there. And he gave them the Mosaic Law, and so they were supposed to follow the law, and a king was supposed to rule by that, and then you had the temple, and then the priest would have their services and their ceremonies according to that law. But Israel had gotten, they're serving other gods, they've made temples to Baal and Ashtaroth and all these false gods, so they weren't even serving God. So by the time you get to Josiah, yeah, there's a temple that's called the Lord's Temple, but he doesn't even know that this Mosaic Law exists. He doesn't know that God was their king because they were following all these other gods. And so they just follow whatever their religion says. They weren't really following what the Bible says to them. And so when they were the temple of God, because they're serving these other gods, they're serving these false gods, and so the temple of the Lord was in bad shape. People neglected it. You know, the roof has leaks in it, the floors are damaged, or the walls are damaged, they got all this, it's not in good shape. And so Josiah says, well, we need to collect some money, and we need to repair this. This is the Lord's house, we need to repair it. And when they're doing that, in 2 Kings 22 and verse 8, there is this significant event here, that when they are working on the house of the Lord, it says in 2 Kings 22 and verse 8, that Hilkiah the high priest said unto Shaphan the scribe, I have found the book of the law in the house of the Lord. And Hilkiah gave the book to Shaphan, and he read it. So basically they found God's law, or the Mosaic Law, that God had given to Israel under Moses. Israel was so far removed from that, they're serving these false gods and these false temples, that apparently the king, Josiah, doesn't even know that God had given Israel a book of the law to follow. And so Josiah hears it. It's read to him. And he just, in verse 19 there in chapter 22, you see that, well, verse 11 in chapter 22, when the king heard it, he rent his clothes. In other words, that was a way to show that he's mourning over it. He's saying, oh no, God gave us this law, and we've disobeyed it. So he just tears his clothes, basically to just show that he's mourning. You know, that'd be a way, like if you cry today, it shows you're upset, you're sorry that something, whatever, happened. Well, back then in that culture, they would tear their clothes to say, oh, this is such a bad thing. That was a way of showing they're mourning over something. So he tears his clothes, and then the king says, okay, well, God gave us his law, and we're supposed to be God's people, so we're going to follow it. And so that's where we are in 2 Kings 23. It says in verse 2, in 2 Kings 23 and verse 2, that the king went up into the house of the Lord, and all the men of Judah and all the inhabitants of Jerusalem with him, and the priests and the prophets and all the people, both small and great. And he read in their ears all the words of the book of the covenant, which was found in the house of the Lord. And the king stood by a pillar and made a covenant before the Lord to walk after the Lord and to keep his commandments and his testimonies and his statutes with all their heart and with all their soul, to perform the words of this covenant that were written in this book. And all the people stood to the covenant. So what he does here in 2 Kings 23, verses 2 and 3, is Israel makes a covenant with God. Basically, a covenant is just like a contract. God says, here are the laws that you're supposed to follow. You know, don't kill, don't steal, don't desire to take the possessions of somebody that's your neighbor. You know, don't lie to people. You know, basically, it's all these rules that God made. And Israel had been serving these other gods. And now they're saying, okay, well, God said to obey this law, so we're going to do it. We make a covenant with God. Basically, they say, we agree to obey God's laws. And really, when it comes to, like, for us today, what we need to understand is that nobody is perfect. You know, we can try to obey these laws that God gives us. We can try to obey His word, but we are going to make mistakes. We're going to do things we shouldn't do. And that's why God sent Jesus. Jesus died on a cross. He died on a cross for our sins. All of us have done things we shouldn't have done, said things we shouldn't have said. We do things that we're not perfect. And God is a holy God. He doesn't do anything wrong. And so we can't live in heaven with God when He is perfect and we're not. And so what God did was He sent His Son Jesus. He died on a cross, and that paid for our sins. And so then when we believe that we recognize we've done some bad things, and then Jesus died for our sins, then God forgives us of our sins. And so then when we die, we get to go to heaven to be with Him. And the purpose of the law is to teach us that. Because He says there in verse 3 that we are going to keep His commandments, His testimony, His statutes with all their heart, with all their soul, to perform the words of this covenant that were written in this book. So they agree to do it, but the reality is they are going to fall short. It's the same thing that Israel did when Moses was taking them out of Egypt. They said they were going to obey the law, but they didn't. Really, the purpose of the law is not there for them to obey it. The purpose of the law is to show them that they are not perfect, that they are sinners, and that's why Jesus came and died on a cross for our sins. That's the lesson of the law. But they don't really learn that at first. At least they're taking a step in the right direction. They recognize that they're serving these other gods and doing all these wicked, evil things. So what they decide to do is to try to serve the Lord. And so what you see then in the rest of this chapter, and we won't, we're almost out of time. We won't have time to go through all this, but what we're going to see is they're going to try to get rid of all of this idol worship and these other temples and these other gods that they're serving. You notice in verse 4, the king commanded Hilkiah the high priest and the priest of the second order and the keepers of the door to bring forth out of the temple of the Lord all the vessels that were made for Baal and for the grove and for all the host of heaven. And he burnt them without or outside Jerusalem in the fields of Kidron and carried the ashes of them unto Bethel. You see there in 23 verse 4 that they have, they're worshiping, Israel was worshiping other gods in the Lord's temple. You know, that's really bad if you do that. You know, it's one thing, it's sort of like for years, I don't know if it's a big thing now, but it used to be your big choices were either people like, when it comes to soda, they'd either like Coke or they like Pepsi. At least that's how it is in America. It used to be. You'd either be, you like Coke or you like Pepsi. Well, it's one thing to drink Coke and, you know, other people are Pepsi lovers and, you know, they don't really see you drinking the Coke. That's okay. But you wouldn't walk into where Pepsi was made and where all these people are working for Pepsi. You wouldn't walk in there and start drinking a Coke in front of them because that's the competition. You know, the people, if everybody's drinking Coke, the Pepsi workers aren't going to be able to sell their Pepsi anymore. So they don't want you drinking a Coke in the Pepsi plant where they're making the Pepsi. You know, that's the enemy. That's the other guy. That's really bad when you do that. Well, that's how you can see here is you've got the temple of the Lord. In the temple of the Lord, you're supposed to serve the Lord. And here it says in verse 4, the first thing they did, they brought vessels made for Baal, for the grove, and all the host of heaven. But they brought them forth out of the temple of the Lord. So it's like drinking that Coke in that Pepsi plant. They've got the temple of the Lord. This is the Lord's house. You serve the Lord here. And even there in the Lord's house, they're serving Baal and the queen of heaven and the host of heaven. They're serving other gods in that temple. That shows you how bad it is. And so the first thing they do is get rid of those and burn them. And then verse 5, he put down the idolatrous priests whom the kings of Judah had obtained or ordained to burn incense in the high places in the cities of Judah and in the places round about Jerusalem. Them also that burnt incense unto Baal, to the sun, to the moon, to the planets, to all the host of heaven. By the way, that's the only time in your Bible planets are mentioned. Verse 6, he brought out the grove from the house of the Lord without Jerusalem under the brook Kidron and burnt it at the brook Kidron and stamped it small to powder and cast the powder thereof upon the graves of the children of the people. So you see there in verse 5 that they're getting rid. They get rid of the bad priest, the idolatrous priest. So you can see what they're doing is they're getting rid of all this religion, this evil worship of other gods in there. Then verse 8, you see they brought out the priest out of the city of Judah and defiled the high places where the priests were. And so you got all these, basically they're getting rid of the bad priest. They're getting rid of the worship of other gods in the Lord's temple. You can see in verse 9, it says, nevertheless, the priest of the high places came not up to the altar of the Lord in Jerusalem, but they did eat of the unleavened bread among their brethren. So in chapter 23 and verse 9, you see these bad priests not serving the Lord. They were required under the Mosaic law to celebrate the Feast of Unleavened Bread or the Passover there in Jerusalem. And instead, they just ate it among their other bad priests. And so they end up being punished. If you go down to verse 20, Josiah the king, it says, he slew all the priests of the high places that were there upon the altars and burnt men's bones upon them and returned to Jerusalem. So the bad priests not serving the Lord. And then verse 20 says, they are killed. So what Josiah is doing, you had such bad, wicked, evil stuff going on in Israel. And Josiah comes in. He actually finds that God gave them a law to follow. And he says, well, we're going to follow that law then. That's God's law. We're going to follow it. And so you can see him cleaning up, getting rid of the worship of other gods, getting rid of the bad priests. And when they would not obey the law, they end up being killed because they're the ones who are leading the people. You know, it's bad enough if somebody is, disobeying the law. But if it's somebody that's a priest, you know, the priest is high up. So if the priest isn't following God's law, then the other people that are listening to the priest aren't going to follow God's law either. So, you know, it may seem like drastic measures to take and kill them for doing that, but really it's important to show that God is the only true God and we need to lead everybody to obey his law and not serve these other gods. And the fact that these priests wouldn't listen, that's why they had to be killed. We're out of time, so we'll have to just stop right there and we'll continue next time. But what we're going to see is that for the rest of this chapter, there's a lot of cleanup that has to be done. And the reason is because of that King Manasseh. He was there for 55 years and he did so many bad things. If you go back to chapter 21 and verse 3, we don't really have time to go through it, but you can see in verse 3 of chapter 21, he built up the high places which Hezekiah's father had destroyed. He reared up altars for Baal, made a grove. He worshipped all the host of heaven. Verse 4, he built altars in the house of the Lord to serve these other gods. And so what Josiah has to do is he has to reverse all that stuff. And it takes a lot of time. A lot of evil had been built up. And so Josiah is one of the rare good kings, and he ends up turning Israel back to the Mosaic Law. There isn't salvation in that because none of us is perfect. You know, you can try your best to try to obey the law, and you won't always do it because you're going to make mistakes. You're not perfect, and that's why Jesus died on a cross for our sins, why God sent Jesus to die for our sins. And when we do mess up and we're not perfect, then those sins are forgiven, and we get to go to heaven when we die. But at least what Josiah is doing is he's setting up a good, he's getting rid of this bad religion, and he's turning people to the Lord so that they can see their sin instead of justifying it by this other, by serving these other gods and things. So we're out of time, so let's close with prayer. Dear Lord, we thank you for the love you gave to us by sending your son Jesus to die on a cross, because no matter as how hard we try, we can never be perfect. And so we thank you that we don't have to be perfect. We thank you that Jesus died for our sins, and that when we trust that he did that, then we get to go to heaven to be with you when we die. In Jesus' name, amen.